I auditioned for a girls group, and I got that. And so I came to New York and stayed here for a while. But then the guy said, you know, I think you should be on your own. So I met this entertainment lawyer, Larry Rudolph. And after meeting him, I decided not to do the girls group anymore. It was like, you know, yang, you know how girls are, you know. Like, you know, forget this. So I went home, I, you know, stayed there for a while, and then pop music came, like, really big in, you know, again. So after that, he sent him a tape and the pictures and the whole deal, and he flew me up here, and I went to several different labels, and I went to Jive, and I was, like, so nervous, you know, because I hadn't sung in so long, you know. I was, like, 15 at the time, and so I came in, and there was, like, all these 10 executives sitting here, and I was like, you know. So I was up there, and I said, you know, I'm just going to sing and just let go and just do the best I can do. My mom was over there, like, lips doing, you know, while I was singing. She was singing along with the words, you know, making sure I was doing okay. So, but then they signed me, so that's how I'm here.
Wow.
Yeah, I guess so. Mainly the only thing it really gets, you know, kind of messes up is the school. You really got to, like, make yourself sit there and really do it, you know. And it's like in history and stuff, it takes like so long just to get one question, you know, and it's like ridiculous, but you just got to stay focused and say, I want to do this, and you've got to do school, you know, you can't leave that out. So it's one thing, that's the only thing it really involves with. And like most of my friends from school, I always, when I go home, I see them and see everyone and see your family. So I want it to be bright colors, baby blue. I love that color, baby blue. I want it to be kind of like Janet Jackson, but a younger version, you know what I mean? Like, because the beats are so good, you know? Like, I want a lot of dancing in it. I like that's, if I wasn't singing, I would hopefully be like a professional dancer or something, you know? So I really don't want to lose that aspect of it.
What sort of dancing?
Like, hip-hop, funky. Funky moves. When I went to the studio, it was like, you know, we knew that, you know, I could sing and everything, but, you know, you always want that unique sound that no one else has on the radio. So when I went to the studio, you know, you found that, you know. Like I was saying, like, we came in with one tape, you know, and it was like, so we had to go through all this stuff to find my sound, find the type of music, where I want to go. So in the studio, when I was singing, all of it just kind of came out, and you could just saw a picture, you know. My family's really supportive, and they're really supportive of what I do, and they're really proud of me, so that makes me feel good. Ever since I was really little, like, you know, we do the pageant thing, you know, and like the reviews, dance reviews, and, you know, all that stuff. But when I was 8, I realized, when I was jumping on the trampoline, my mom realized I could sing, you know. I was just singing, and ever since then, you know, the competitions and all that stuff. And I got connected with the Mickey Mouse Club. I auditioned for that in Atlanta, and I was actually too young, so, but instead the guy sent me to New York and gave me an agency in New York, and I went there and I auditioned there. I went to Hatchet. He's in New York. It's called the Off-Broadway Dance Center. And I just danced there for a while. And then after that, I went to, you know, acting and dancing and all that stuff. And then I auditioned for the Mickey Mouse Club again. And I got it after that. And then we flew to Florida. And by then, I was like 12 or 11, because I'd been taking the summers, you know, in New York. And then I auditioned again, and I got the Mickey Mouse Club. And it was a lot of fun, because there were, like, a bunch of kids my age, you know, and it was, like, everybody was so sweet and just was gorgeous there, you know. So it was a lot of fun. I have a little sister. She's 7, and she's in the first grade. I have an older brother. He's 20. And I'm just in the middle of the family, and I've always wanted to sing. It's just something, you know, I've always wanted to do. So, and I would be in competitions and everything, and I would just travel back and forth to a bunch of different places, and make a long story short, I'm just here now. So. Usually when I have free time, I do my schoolwork, but like if I'm home and I just want to be with my friends, I love going to the beach, getting a tan, I love doing that, and reading books, and always try to go to dance class when I'm up here with Hatchet. He's great, I love, he's like so much fun, he makes it, you know, he gets everybody clapping and everything. I love doing that, and I love shopping. So that's my main thing. When I was little, like Whitney Houston, of course, and Mariah Carey, and I love, like, you know, listening to Michael Jackson in my room and dancing around and being silly, you know. That was fun. I love his music. So, like, you know, Thriller and all those songs, I like those. I've always just, like, loved Mariah Carey, I guess, like, because she, like, writes her music, most of her music, and she's got, comes up with the best melodies, you know. I think she's an incredible singer. Her range is, like, from here to here, you know, and she's so beautiful. She's probably my role model. My wildest dream?
Mm-hmm.
Like, what I want?
Mm-hmm.
I guess I'm experiencing what I want right now, you know, just making the album, and it's going to be, like, I'll be the happiest person in the world, like, when I have a great show, you know, and, like, if I get to go on tour or something and have my dancers with me, and we just get out there and perform and kick butt and just do real good, you know, that'll feel so good, because I love performing. I'd rather perform than do anything. I just wanted, you know, to be able to perform. I love performing and, like, have my own dancers and just get out there and let people hear my music and people be able to relate to me with me, you know, and, oh, I love her songs, you know, and, you know, just want to go out there and meet me, you know what I'm saying? And so, like, I want to be, like, an artist that everybody can relate to and, like, wants to, you know, be like, and say, oh, I like her, you know, I want to go out there and be like her, you know.